In this video, we're going to explain how to use the parameter property of the content display. This property lets us use one content screen to display the data of more than one equipment, that could be pumps, motors, etc. We're going to use this sample project, which already has three motors and some things pre-configured. The first step is the variables. For this example, we're going to use internal variables, but they can also be external. We created a structure with each of the parameters of the equipment, which in this case is a motor. Then we created an array using that structure. We created a second array of pool variables. The dimension has to match the number of equipment. In this case, it's 3. This array will be used for the content display visibility. Here you will find all of our variables. Note that the initial value for the visibility variables is 1. Now let's go back to our screen. As you can see, each lamp and setup button is referencing a variable from the array from 0 to 2. Then for the content display, we change the parameter ID from 0 to 2 accordingly. Now we go to the content display. In here, we're going to create a script using the parameter property for the data that is displayed. First, we're going to create the script to close the content screen. Add a touch trigger and a bool value change operation underneath. On the trigger, add a screen object, which will be switch1. On the bool value change, we're going to leave it a set and add a variable box. On a side, we're also going to add an object box. Here comes the interesting part. The variable is the content underscore visibility array we created. But instead of using an index value, we're going to use the parameter property. So on the extra object box we added, we're going to select content1.parent.parameter. We're going to copy this and use it as an index for the array, like so. Then we can delete the extra object box. The next script is for the equipment variables. Add a value change trigger and a value change operation underneath. On the trigger, add a screen object which will be toggleSwitch1.currentValue. On the value change operation, we're going to leave it a set and add a variable box. On the variable, we're going to do something similar as before, but now with the motor variables. Instead of using an index value, we are adding the content1.parent.parameter. Then copy and paste the object box and put it to the right. Repeat this process with all of the objects that are used for the equipment data. Once finished, let's test the project.